This video is brought to you by Gomer Pyle.
New gun laws on Friday that he says will enhance public safety while protecting the rights of law-abiding citizens.
And critics say these new measures will turn law-abiding gun owners into second-class citizens, and they don't want to do anything to reduce gun violence or to prevent mass shootings. KUSI's Steve Bosch has details.
These new laws prevent gun owners from loaning a gun to anybody but an immediate family member, and for a short period of time. They also ban the possession of magazines with a capacity to hold more than 10 rounds, and require anybody with such magazines to turn them in. And they increase penalties for filing false reports of stolen guns. There will be many lawful gun owners who will unknowingly be out of compliance with these new laws and subject to prosecution.
Before we start eroding liberty, and here we are on July 4th, we're talking about how hard we fought for our freedom and our liberty. Let's not take it away from everyday citizens. Let's focus on penalizing those criminals who violate the law.
There are gun owners like this man from the Daily Shooter website who refuse to comply with these new laws.
I won't comply because you do not have the right to step on my rights. You don't have the right to go above the Constitution and take away my rights as an individual and a citizen of this country.
Critics say this is a knee-jerk reaction to the mass killings in San Bernardino.
We're not attacking the real issue, which is crime and violence in general. We're trying to control gun crime. And if you attack crime in general and decrease crime, you're going to decrease gun crime.
These new laws also require a background check to purchase ammunition and close the bullet button loophole, which makes it easier to change magazines. This circumvented the assault weapon ban. Senator Joel Anderson says these laws will not prevent criminals from getting guns or ammunition.
They'll use an excuse of a shooting to take law-abiding citizens' rights away from them, but they do nothing to enforce it on criminals. If we take guns from gangbangers, if we take guns from criminals, that makes a lot more sense to me than taking the Second Amendment rights from others.
If you steal a gun, it's a misdemeanor. If you steal a laptop computer, it's a felony. Assemblyman Jim Cooper introduced a bill to make stealing a gun a felony. It was vetoed. Steve Bosch, KUSI News.